नमस्ते गुरु जी।
लेट्स स्टार्ट।
यस गुरु
हम शंकराचार्य मध्यमाम अस्मदाचार्य पर्यंता वंदे गुरु परंपरा श्रुति स्मृति पुराणानां आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्तिभेद विभागिनी व्योमवत् व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु। ओम शांति शांति शांति। यो ब्रह्माणं विदधाति पूर्वं यो वेदाश्च प्रणोति तस्मै तपुंहदेवमात्मबुद्धि प्रकाशं मुमुक्षुर्वै शरणमहं प्रपद्ये। ओम शांति शांति शांति। श्री चिद्घन गणेशाय नमो। मह्यं सुखं नित्यं सुप्रकाशं व्यापकं नाम रूपयो अधिष्ठानं बुद्धि बोध्यं बुद्धे दृक्यत्व निर्मलं अपारं सर्व वेदांत वेद्यं प्रत्येक परम महा तदेवाहन मत्तो इति मे निश्चिता मतिः। ओके, इन दी लास्ट पार्ट हा we close this section where the guru said that the abheda between jiva and ishvara is a fact. Although you have samsara in you and ishvara does not have samsara, still there is aikya. He is karma phala data, but karma and karmas are useful as revealed in the Shruti, because that was the question. The Ishvara, who is karma phala data, these are the questions. Answer is not given yet, but all this was taught saying that there is Aikya. Hold on to Aikya, that jnana will lead to moksha. But how is the vyavastha? Ishvara is a karma phaladata, Shruti revealing karma and upasana, which will not be useful if there is aikya. So the question was raised from the perspective of the jiva as well as from the perspective of Ishvara. If there is aikya, then upasana will not be possible and karma will also not be possible. There will be no adhikari for karma, thereby karma is not possible, and there won't be any upasya devata, so upasana will not be possible. And Ishvara, who is karma phala data, he is needed because karma itself cannot give results, being jada. And thereby the question was raised. The answer is not given, I'm sorry. Answer is already given, but then elaborately with different methodologies it has not been given. Tasma jivatma paramatmanoho ekatvam na yujyate iti. Thereby ekatvam is not tenable. This is the Purva Pakshi's question. Who is tattva drishti here? Ayancha pramanagata samshaya. So prameyagata samshaya and pramanagata samshaya we saw. Pramanagata samshaya will go by shravana. Prameyagata samshaya will go by manana. Shravana also has yukti involved, which are about the tatparya of the shruti. And prameya definitely has, prameyagata samshaya will go only by manana. Manana definitely has more yukti leading to how it is possible. I know what Shruti is saying, tatparya nishya is there, but how is it possible? That understanding becomes firm with manana, all the samshayas go away, and thereby nishtha nididhyasana is possible. Anyway, so answer given is what? In the 172 to 185 avarta, this section, गुरु सेस स्वरूप भेदा जीव ब्रह्मणोर ऐक्य असंगति इति शंकाया समाधानम। द डाउट इज रिमूव्ड बाय सेइंग दैट व्हाट इज द डाउट रिगार्डिंग असंगति। इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल टू हैव ऐक्य बिटवीन जीव एंड ब्रह्मण। व्हाई? बिकॉज स्वरूप भेदा इज देयर। स्वरूप भेदा दिस हेतौ पंचमी, बिकॉज स्वरूप ऑफ ईश्वर ब्रह्म and jiva is different. This is the samshaya really, and that leads to that this wrong assumption. There is an assumption that swarupa of jiva and brahma are different. With that assumption as basis, the conclusion is wrong that there is no possibility of oneness between the two. What is the samadhana? Akashasiva chaitanyasyapi chaturvidho bhedaha. So it's a very interesting explanation. This is taken up by Panchadashikara also. How do you explain this? Taking Akasha as example and then Pratibimba together, it is explained. Akashasiva chaitanyasyapi chaturvidho bhedaha. There are four types of divisions, as though Akasha cannot have divisions, but still there are divisions. In the case of Akasha, how you have names, similarly here also you have name-based divisions. Chaitanyasya, of the consciousness also, Brahma. He Somya, Tvat Sandeha Nivartaka Vichara Rupam Upadesham Shrunu. So listen to this teaching, which is Vichara Rupa. Because Vichara Sagara, you cannot do away with Vichara. Jnana can take place only by Vichara. Atma Vichara. All the Sandehas will go only by Vichara. So Sandeha Nivartaka, and this Sandeha is yours. So Tvat Sandeha Nivartaka Vichara Rupam Upadesham Shrunu. Listen to it. Yatha Ekasyeva Akashasya. In the example, in exemplified Chaitanya, Ekasyeva Chaitanyasya. So Yatha Ekasyeva Akashasya. What are the Bhedas? Ghatakashaha, Jalakashaha, Meghakashaha, Mahakashaha iti Chaturvida Bhedosti, Tatha Ekasyeva Chaitanyasya Kutastaha, Jivaha, Ishwaraha, Brahmacheti, Bheda Chatushtayamasti. So in the example, Ghatakasha, Jalakasha, Meghakasha, Mahakasha, in the exemplified, Kutastha, Jiva, Ishwara, Brahma. These are the four divisions. These are name-based divisions. And of course, there will be Upadhi-based divisions. So let's look at the example first before we go. So we can, you know, speed through the section. If you understand, let's look at the overview. What is Ghatakasha? I'll just give a simple overview. Then details we'll see in the Moola and Tippana. Ghatakasha we all know. Mahakasha also we know. Mahakasha is total space. Ghatakasha is what? Individualized pot space. However, the difference is Ghatakasha here is not the space inside alone. The example here is of a pot which is filled up with water. Jalapurna Ghataha. That Jalapurna Ghataha, what is the space taken by the Jalapurna Ghataha? It is not just the empty space within. It is the space including its boundary. Because the boundary of the pot belongs to the pot. It does not belong to the Mahakasha. Obviously, Mahakasha has no association with any Upadhi. That is the Chaitanya, which is Brahma. Then Ghatakasha is what then? It is like Kutastha. It is also Akasha. So Chaitanya. Kutastha is Chaitanya. Ghatakasha is also Akasha, like Mahakasha. There is no difference between Ghatakasha and Mahakasha. But still the name given to Ghatakasha, to that Akasha, is based on the space taken by the Jalapurna Ghataha. A water-filled pot, whatever space it takes, that is called as Ghatakasha here. What is Jalakasha and Meghakasha? We'll see. I'll just explain. Jalakasha is this space reflected in the water, including the space of Ghata itself. So Ghatakasha plus the Pratibimbita Akasha in the Jala. Because Jala will have a reflection of something. We'll see how Akasha reflects. There is objection to that also. So Jala Akasha is the Jala is water in the Ghata. That Jala will also reflect Akasha. That reflected Akasha plus the original Akasha here, which was there in the Ghata, the space taken by the Ghata, both put together is called as Jala Akasha. And this itself is created by the boundary of the Ghata. So Upadhi is the Ghata. Then another upadhi is the jala itself, which reflects the akasha, which is in the exemplified chaitanya, that is comparable to jiva in the exemplified. So jiva is who? Jiva is one who has the upadhi of the shariratraya. There is an antakarana, which is the reflecting medium into which the consciousness chaitanya reflects, and jiva is this unholy combination. Jiva is not just the, like the jalakasha is not just ghatakasha, it is not only the jala itself, it is not the jala, it is the akasha reflected in the jala. So it's a combination, jalakasha, the way jalakasha is a combination, similarly jiva is a combination of the chaitanya, which has an upadhi, and in that upadhi there is a reflection of chaitanya. So it's a combination of at least two, but we can take all three. Similarly, at the total level, a larger body. So here, what is this jala? This is potable water, which is drinkable water. That drinkable water is rainwater. It cannot be ocean water. So the example of ocean shouldn't be taken here. Here the example is taken megha kasha. Megha is a cloud. The cloud water is a rainwater which will rain into this ghata and then will be collected as potable water, drinkable water, which is sweet water. And that sweet water is where the jala kasha is seen. So in the example, you have megha at the total level. All the water that has been collected in the pot is nothing. In various pots, in hundreds of pots across, thousands and crores of pots across the world, across the universe, all clean water collected is through the rain. And those are in the cloud. So cloud example is given. Now considering that the cloud is there, the cloud will take up some space. That space, like the ghata takes some space, megha will take a huge space. That space, which includes all the water which has been collected. So it is not just one example. You have to take multiple pots where water is collected, and all that water has come from the clouds. So cloud has water. It still has water. It is going to rain further. It's a continuous activity. Like the shariras keep on coming from Ishvara. Everything is born from Ishvara. Shariras also keep coming from Ishvara. Similarly, the rain keeps on coming from the megha. Just like this jalakasha, jala reflects akasha, inclusive of the akasha of the ghata, wherever the container, basically, wherever the container is, whatever is the container space plus the space reflected by the contained jala, similarly, the contained jala in the megha, the cloud, which is the container, which takes some space, will also reflect the water, will reflect, jala will reflect space. Both put together along with the boundary is what is megha-kasha, comparable to Ishvara in the exemplified. So this is the vyavastha. Now, so since we have seen an overview, this section should be easier comparatively. Esham swarupam vichara purvakam yada samyak vijanasi tada tvadiya sandehanam samadhanam tvam swayameva janiyaha. You would automatically know yourself, says the guru. I'll explain the example. He says, once you understand the example, vichara purvakam, then what will happen? If you inquire into this, what will happen? Samyak vijanasi. Once you understand this, then in the example, esham swarupam, all the four in the example, once you understand, or rather you understand the exemplified four, the swarupa of the exemplified four through the vichara purvakam, means you using the example, you understand the swarupa of the example and extend it to the exemplified, then samyak vijanasi, when you know it very well, doubtlessly, then what will happen? Tada tvadiya sandehana. All these doubts that you have raised earlier, you will resolve them yourself. Samadhanam tvam swayameva janiya. You will yourself know what is the resolution. Siddhanta is simple. I have already explained that Siddhanta you hold on to. Everything else will fall into place by the prakriya, methodology. Atastesham swarupam मया अभिधीयमानम अवधारय. सो एज आई एम टीचिंग यू होल्ड ऑन टू दिस टीचिंग अंडरस्टैंड द टीचिंग फॉर व्हाट इट इज द मेथडोलॉजी तद अधिगमेन व्हाट विल हैपन थ्रू दैट अंडरस्टैंडिंग तव निस्संशय ज्ञानोदय द्वारा जन्मादि दुखम निशेषम विनश्येत तव. सो योर तव निस्संशय ज्ञानोदय द्वारा through the understanding as taught using whatever methodology, what will happen is that your jnana that comes up for you, that jnana which will be doubtless nissamshaya, without any obstacles, it will take away vinashyet, it would destroy janmadi dukkham, samsara dukkha, which is what your objection is. Mai pratiyate, that will go away, nishesham. Nothing will remain. None of these dukkha will be felt. All of these will go away. So what is it? Chaturvidha akasha varnanam. So these have to be explained. Just names have been given. They have been listed. What is ghatakasha? So that is seen here. Ghatakasha jalapurita ghatavasthanaya yavan akashaha avakasham dadati tavan akasha ghatakasha iti panditai ruchyate. So the sadhu says, this is well known. Panditas, scholars explain it this way. Shastra, shastra, scholars in shastra, they explain what is ghatakasha. Whatever is the space needed, avakasham dadati. Akasha, the lakshana of akasha is what? Avakasha pradatra akasham. Akasha is one that gives opportunity. Avakasha is literally opportunity. For anything to take place, for even for Vayu to come up, Vayu needs space. Some space. Now, not space as in Akasha, space as in where you have to keep something. For something to happen, an opportunity has to be given. That opportunity can come only when it is given. And that giver is Akasha. That is the definition of Akasha. Lakshana, Avakasha Pradatru Akasham. Or if you take pullinga, avakasha pradata akasha. Akasha can be, akasha is declines in both genders. It is masculine as well as neuter. So pullinge napunsaki linge cha. So space given to jalapurita ghata, to place, avasthana, to place, you need some space. Whatever space is needed for a water filled pot, that space is called as ghatakasha. Now there is an objection to this. Panditair uchyati, you are saying, but then what is the common knowledge? Nanu ghatad bahischita akasha mahakasha tasmad bhinna ghatantar varti akasha ghatakasha iti cha prasiddhi. The total space outside the ghata is mahakasha, and within the ghata is what is called as ghatakasha. Why would you separate it out and say that? To give a separate definition as ghatakasha is not the ghatantarvarti akasha, but it is the space taken by the entire pot, so which includes the boundary. There the answer is tatra ghatakashasya prasiddham lakshanam vihaya ghatantara karane, lakshanantara karane kim prayojanam. Why would you give another definition is the question, giving up the famous explanation. Well-known explanation is what? Ghatantarvarti akasha ghatakasha. Why do you say entire space taken by the pot? Kim prayojanam? There has to be some basis why you have given a different definition taken to something which is not famous, which is known among scholars. Why would you bring a scholarly explanation when a well-known yogika? Why would you bring a kind of a, not a yogika, but when a Rudhi Artha is applicable, why would you bring a scholarly interpretation? That is the question. Kim prayojanam iti ched atra uchyate. Ghatantarvarti akasha ghatakasha iti prasiddha lakshana svikare. If you take your explanation, which is also valid, if you take that, what is the issue? Yatra ghata yatra vartate sa akasha panchama kapala akasha. This is a typo here. Kapala akasha iti vaktavyam bhavet. Then you have to explain what is the space taken. So space outside the pot is mahakasha, inside the pot is ghatakasha. What about the space taken by the Upadhi Ghata itself, the Ghata boundary? That is that you will have to explain as that space. If there is a thick pot, it will be easier to see that the space taken by the pot boundary, there is space there also. So you have got an inside space, outside space, but in between space you haven't got. That will have another definition called Kapala Akasha. You'll have to bring that also. Sacha Pancha Prakara Akasha Shastra Aprasiddha. That is not dealt with in, that has no use. In the example, it has no use. Therefore, Siddhante Arambhavada Anangikara. You cannot, Arambhavada, nothing is created afresh. So none of that is needed. The pot is not created, pot space is not created, the boundary space is also not created per se. So in Arambhavada there may be some use, but here there is no use. Tasmad idam dvitiyam lakshanam ashritam sadhu. Therefore you should take the dvitiya lakshana, which is pandite ruchyate ghatakasha. What is ghatakasha? The entire space taken by the pot, which is filled with water. Why filled with water? Because we need the water also to explain the pratibimbavada. That is ghatakasha. Then what is jalakasha? Jalapurne ghate nakshatradi sahita akasha pratibimbati tadrusha akasha pratibimbo ghatakashascha iti ubhayam militva jalakasha ityuchyate. Ubhayam militva, putting them both together. What are those two? Jalapurne ghate nakshatradi sahita akasha. The akasha which holds nakshatra, because akasha is avakasha pradhatu. It is giving avakasha to nakshatra, etc. In the sky, whatever is there, you see stars, you see the moon, you see the sun, whatever is there in the sky, the birds, etc., all of those are in the akasha. Actually, it is a mahakasha. That akasha, though, which reflects the entire mahakasha, will not reflect. Whatever can reflect, that will reflect in the jala. In the jala, which jala? The jala in the ghata. So ghata jale, the jala purne ghate, in that jala purna ghata, jala is going to reflect the outside space, but then there is ghata, which also has its own space. So tadrusha akasha pratibimba, the akasha pratibimba in the jala, along with the ghata akasha, which has been defined earlier. That space taken by the pot, plus the space reflected by the jala inside the pot, ubhayam militva jalakasha ityuchyate. Now there is an objection to that also. What is a pratibimba here? Akasha pratibimba along with nakshatra. Jalapurite ghate drishyamana akasha pratibimbo ghatantaravarti akasha pratibimba iti shanka vyavruttaye nakshatradi sahita iti akasha visheshanam. Jalapurita ghate, in the pot filled with water, drishyamana akasha pratibimba. You see some pratibimba there. Now, generally, what do you see? You see things reflected. You don't look for akasha being reflected. But without akasha, they cannot have reflection of the things. That which holds the things which are reflected, that space should also reflect in jala. This is unthought. Many don't think about it. When you look at a mirror, you see your face in the mirror, but this face, the body is held by akasha. That akasha is also reflected there. But we count only the things, not the akasha. Space, we do not think about the space being reflected, but it is there. Ghatantaravarti akasha pratibimbah iti shanka vyavrutte. If you think that the akasha, ghatantaravarti akasha pratibimbah, the akasha which is reflected, is the akasha within? No, it is not the akasha within. The akasha is outside. That is reflected. Iti shanka vyavrutti. To resolve such kind of a doubt, if it comes up, what is this akasha? That akasha is not the akasha within. It is the akasha outside. Nakshatradi sahita. That's why it is mentioned nakshatradi sahita. Apicha, jalam vina pratibimba sambhavat, akasha pratibimba ityanena jalastha ghatastha jalasahita akasha pratibimbo grahyaha. And without the water, you cannot have pratibimba. You cannot have reflection without the water. Therefore, akasha pratibimba ityanena, when you say akasha pratibimba, देर इत्यनेन घटस्थ जल सहित आकाश द आकाश द जल विच इज रिफ्लेक्टिंग दैट जल ऑल्सो कैनॉट रिफ्लेक्ट विदाउट जल देर कैनॉट बी रिफ्लेक्शन बट जल कैनॉट रिफ्लेक्ट अनलेस इट हैज अ स्पेस टू बी हेल्ड जल हैज टू बी हेल्ड समवेयर देन अलोन जल कैन बी देर टू रिफ्लेक्ट समथिंग देर फोर ऑल्दो विदाउट जल देर कैनॉट बी रिफ्लेक्शन बट विदाउट द घटस्थ जल सहित आकाश द आकाश विच इज देर इन घटाकाश विदाउट द घटाकाश जल कैनॉट बी देर एंड विदाउट जल यू कैनॉट हैव प्रतिबिंब देर फोर द प्रतिबिंब विच इज देर इन द जल विच प्रतिबिंब आकाश आउटसाइड आकाश दैट नीड्स द इनसाइड आकाश घट घट अंतर्वर्ती आकाश ऑल्सो शुड बी देर टू होल्ड द जल टू क्रिएट द प्रतिबिंब सो लिटिल कॉम्प्लेक्स सेटअप बट नथिंग सो कॉम्प्लेक्स इट इज ऑल लॉजिकल इत्यनेन घटस्थ जल सहित आकाश प्रतिबिंबो ग्राह्यः नाउ द ऑब्जेक्शन देयर देयर इज एन ऑब्जेक्शन हियर ननु आकाशस्य प्रतिबिंबो न युज्यते आकाश कैनॉट रिफ्लेक्ट यू आर सेइंग नक्षत्रादि आई एग्री विथ नक्षत्रादि प्रतिबिंबति नक्षत्रादि सहित आकाश प्रतिबिंबति दैट आई डू नॉट एग्री So the Purva Pakshi says, how can Akasha have a reflection? Nanu, Akashasya Pratibimbo na yujyata. Na yujyate, kintu, kevala nakshatradinam eva sa yujyate. Only the things are reflecting. Stars are reflecting, the moon reflects in water, the sun reflects in water, the birds reflect in water. I mean, where is the space which is reflecting? I don't see space being reflected. Therefore, it is not valid. Rupa Bhavat, and if you question why, not only do I not see, even if you say, even if you don't see, think you will see, you will understand. No, I'll not understand because Rupa Bhavat na akashasya pratibimbaha sambhavati. For anything to reflect, what can reflect? Rupa can reflect. Rupa is primarily color as per Tarkikas. Then we extend it as form also. So Rupa is primarily the color but also the form whichever meaning you take the color can reflect or the form can reflect how can roopa rahita akasha reflect roopavata hoi pratibimbaha syat only that which is roopavan alone can reflect roopa rahita cannot have a reflection at all and this is an objection given to against pratibimbavada also bhamatikara raises an objection with pratibimbavada he says pratibimbavada is not right why because chaitanya cannot reflect chaitanya is nirguna nirguna cannot reflect so the answer you know you can extend that answer you cannot say it cannot reflect the reflection itself is anirvachaniya how the reflection takes place some example is given It is not everything is not as per the example. Do you understand that there is a reflection? Then something like a reflection. There is an you call it an abhasa, whatever you call it, it is some kind of a reflection. That reflection need not be only roop of some guna. Whatever happens in the reflection, a similarity is seen in the result. Through the resultant, we make a prakriya. That prakriya is not idam ittham. So if the objection is there, that objection is similar to the objection raised here. Rupavato hi pratibimbasyat. So gunavata hi pratibimbasyat. Tasmat na akashasya pratibimbo yujyate iti chet. No. That objection is not valid. If you say akasha does not have rupa, therefore, and generally guna also we can say, but akasha is shabda guna. Extending to exemplified chaitanya. जले वाई वाई इट इज नॉट वैलिड ऑब्जेक्ट इट इज नॉट अ वैलिड ऑब्जेक्शन जले आकाश प्रतिबिंब अनभ्युपगमे इफ यू डू नॉट एक्सेप्ट द आकाश बीइंग रिफ्लेक्टेड इन जल देन गोष्प सॉरी गोष्पद परिमाणक स्वल्प जले महागजादि परिमाणक गभीरतायाः प्रतिबिंबो न स्यात् एन एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन Assume that the Gosh pada is a the foot of the foot of the cow. Gosh pada. Say, assume that a cow is walking and it's got a very hard foot. You know, if you've seen a calf dancing around, if you're playing with a calf and it dances, it steps on your feet, then you'll know how hard the stomping is. Maybe not as as hard as the or as strong as a horse's stomping, but still it is quite strong. The calf's feet also hurt if the calf jumps on your feet. Now imagine that cow which is running and there is a soft ground, it stomps on that and there is a mark left, there is a deep impression left. Now that gosh pada parimana is a measure of the cow's foot. So you have we have 1 foot, 2 foot, all this, 5 feet, whatever is the measure. Now here the measure is not given of a human feet, but here the measure is of the cow's foot. It will leave a deep impression in the ground, and then it rains. When it rains, it will hold water, and there a person can look into that water. That water will reflect the person. It will reflect the gaja also. Mahagaja. Gaja is huge. An elephant is huge. Whereas gosh pada is a small foot. That's all. A foot deep. Not a foot deep. The cow's foot deep. That kind of a small, few inches maybe. Few inches. How deep will it go? Maybe a few centimeters. Few centimeters, and there will be a little width there. But in the depth of the water, which is only as deep as the impression left there, the hole in the ground, there the water will reflect something. If you look at the depth and the depth of the water there, how can it reflect if you stand vertically above it? The gaja stands, the elephant stands vertically above it, and you watch the water, you can see the elephant completely there. How can you see the elephant there, which is passing by? Just look at the water, you can see. The space which holds that huge elephant should be reflected there. Otherwise, you cannot see the elephant in that tiny space. Because you have to explain how the tiny space is showing the huge elephant. Only if the space which is reflected there is the space of the elephant. You have to accept the space being reflected. Otherwise, it cannot hold a huge elephant. You have to show me the space. If the argument is space is not reflected, then you have to show me these parimana of the jala. What is the measure of the jala? The jala's measure is the gosh pada parimanaka akasha. It cannot, the jala which is held by the akasha in the gosh pada parimana chidra, that chidra cannot hold more water than its own volume. So the volume of the hole in the ground is only so small that it can hold only as much water. It cannot hold beyond that. That water cannot reflect the entire elephant because there is not enough space there. So, but the reflection does take place. Therefore, you have to explain now, without the huge space, how can there be the Mahagaja Parimana Gabhira Pratibimba? It is not possible. Therefore, you have to accept the Gaja is seen because the Gaja Parimana Parimanaka Akasha is there in reflected in the Jala. So, through the example, it is established that Jale Akasha Pratibimba Anabhyupagame Gosh pada parimanaka swalpa jale mahagajadi parimanaka gabhirataayaha pratibimbo nasyat. But it is there, you see, experienceable. Maybe not an elephant, you stand in front of, in comparison to the foot of the cow, you yourself are like a gaja. You huge, so you can see your reflection in that water. Thereby, tatha upalabhyamanatvad, since that is experienceable, akasha pratibimbo angikarya eva. You have to accept the akasha as being reflected there. न च नीरूप पदार्थ प्रतिबिंबो नास्ति इति वाच्यम एंड यू कैन नॉट से रूप रहित देयर इज नो प्रतिबिंब व्हिच इज रूप रहित इट इज नॉट पॉसिबल इति न वाच्यम यू शुड नॉट आर्ग्यू दैट नो इट हैज नो रूप सो देयर कैन नॉट बी प्रतिबिंब पॉसिबल नीरूपस्यापि शब्दस्य प्रतिध्वनि प्रदर्शन निर्देश निदर्शनात् सो प्रति सॉरी प्रतिध्वनि दर्शनात् As I said earlier, you know, you break on the line, somehow my eyes see more things. So, nirupasya api shabdasya pratidhvani darshanat. Pratidhvani is like a reflection. Dash shabda hai. Pratidhvani is an echo. Echo is like a reflection. Reflection of sound. Does the sound reflect? Yes, I hear the echo. So, it reflects. It bounces off the wall. So, it's a reflection. Now, that reflection, the way the light bounces off a reflecting medium, sound bounces off a reflecting medium. It is possible to reflect sound. Does sound have rupa? Shabda does not have rupa. So, shabdasya nirupasya api shabdasya, that which is bereft of rupa, that kind of shabda has pratidhvani. Therefore, pratibimba, pratidhvani being like pratibimba, pratibimba cannot be negated, cannot be said, it is not there for a nirupa padartha. Sacha pratidhvani shabdasya pratibimba eva, tasmat nirupasya api akashasya pratibimbo yujyata eva. Therefore, even if the akasha is formless, it is also colorless till it can have pratibimba and so can the exemplified Chaitanya also. We'll see more in the next part. Huh? We look at Meghakasha and Mahakasha later. There is a second point here which we'll have a look at in the Tippana. Sukhan Nityam Saprakasham Vyapakan Namurupe Adhishtanam Buddhya Bodhyam Buddhya Nirkitna Nirmalam Aparam Sarvedanta Vedyam Pratyak Param Maha Tadeva Namatvam Dime Nishchita Matihi तत्सत नमस्ते
हरिओम